Okay, so mine was really simple with my action plan. I like the cards, like the robot cards with the green and orange and red, and using that for my ESL kids, for them to give me a sign, are they okay, do they understand, do they not understand. I thought that was really practical, and also the kids, we do it anyway as an assessment tool, but it was really practical and something for them to touch and feel, and they love that sort of thing, especially in year one.
I like the chips idea.
Yeah.
Which would enable all children to have no talking, because we definitely have some children who just
always
talk, and they don't put their hands up, and they just shout out, whereas the chips will enable the quieter ones to actually have an input in the lesson, which I thought was a good idea.
And for me, like, one of the things that I really enjoyed was that there were so many good ideas electronically, the apps and so on that were introduced. The pace was good as well, though, so we didn't dwell, but I think it trusts teachers to go and explore the ones which appeal to you and the ones that you think would be good for your particular setting or your subject. So I think, yeah, Spiral for me would be one of the ones that I'm interested in finding out more about. I like the idea of using YouTube videos but with a bit more analysis and putting your own questions into to sort of probe students' understanding and open out the discussion a little bit, maybe.
Yeah, I really like that one as well. We use a lot of YouTube videos with our kids too, and being able to stop it, and we usually do stop it and talk about it, but for something a bit more interactive, it keeps the kids engaged a lot more as well, not just us talking all the time.